It was perilous, skillful work, and the master of the mills watched with approval the splendid efforts of these intrepid lumberjacks. He only waited until the rattling chains of the cranes were lowered and the first log was grappled and lifted like a match out of the water and hauled up to the milling floor. Then, with a sigh, as of a man relieved of a great strain, he turned away and passed out of his yards. It was the first day for a fortnight he had gone to his house for dinner. His home was a small house of weatherboarding, with a veranda all creeper-grown, as were most of the houses in the village. It had only one story, and every window had a window-box full of simple flowers. It stood in a patch of garden that was chiefly given up to vegetables, with just a small lawn of mean-looking turf with a center bed of flowers. Along the top-rail fence which enclosed it were, set at regular intervals, a number of small blue gum and spruce trees. It was just such an abode as one might expect Dave to possess, simple, useful, unpretentious. It was the house of a man who cared nothing for luxury. Utility was the keynote of his life, and the little trivial decorations in the way of creepers, flowers, and such small luxuries were due to the gentle, womanly thought of his old mother, with whom he lived, and who permitted no one else to minister to his wants.